Hey folks, it's Frithgar here, how you doing? I'm just taking the last full load of grain from that field right behind us, field 12. The combine I have already taken up the top of the field 1 and it's done a little bit round the edge, it's now waiting to be emptied. We've got the Challenger with the seed drill back here, so I'm going to need to take the Tatra truck with the trailers up to the top field so that we can start emptying out the combine up there. This one I'm going to bring over here and empty out. I had quite a lot of people actually saying to me, why did I get this little lizard trailer? It doesn't really fit because the amount that we can take in the fence compared with what we can take into the trailer, it's not a good match. And they thought, well, actually I should be using the Brantner trailer. Maybe the Metal Tech one, the 8,000 litre Metal Tech, or the Brantner. I should use either one of those rather than a Lizard. It would fit better than the one that we've got at the moment. So I will consider that. I might change that one over. I didn't actually do any more here. I've still got the Ponzi Scorpion there ready to use. I finished up doing the harvest and moved the combine and the tractor and stuff. We've got trees to do. Main reason being is there's other things that I'd like to do, and some of these I want to do on camera. So I sort of it wasn't the right time to go and finish doing all of that. Let me just empty out this one. My question I asked you all last week was, do you want me to leave this map after 100 episodes, or do you want me to stay here for at least 150 episodes? Now, I did have several people saying to me, actually, this is starting to get a bit boring. We've been on this same map for ages now. We've done 80 episodes here. They'd like me to move now, sooner rather than later. And I hear where you're coming from, and I do sort of understand that some of you are getting a bit fed up with this map because we've been here for a very long time. However, I did put it to a vote previously, and I did ask everybody, and it was quite a majority that said they wanted me to stay here for a minimum of 100 episodes. So because I asked it previously and it's already sort of done and in place, I'm going to stay here for the 100 episodes at least. Now, the results to this question, they did surprise me a little bit. We had, let me just go over here. We want to go on to this tractor. So we had 3,445 responses to that particular question, which I thought was really good. That was a really high response rate. Absolutely fantastic. And of the 3,445 people, 641 would like me to stay here until at least 150 episodes. Quite a few people said that they would like me to just stay and run Goldcrest as like a permanent series, just stay here until FS19 comes out. But 2,804 people said they'd like me to leave as soon as possible, and quite a lot of those said they'd rather I didn't even wait for another, because including this week, we've got another 7 weeks here to go. But because of what I asked previously, I am going to stay here for the 100 episodes. So this one here is full, so I'm just moving it. There's quite a lot of weight on that, actually. And we'll come back out. Now I'm going to go back up to 5x speed. Oops. No, I've got to turn up. I really hope that that hasn't come up. I might have to just go and edit that little bit out, because you do get, I want to do that for 5x speed. There we go. You do get some issues sometimes with, what's it called? What's the word I'm looking for? Oh, I can't remember what I'm, what's the word I'm looking for? Copyright. Ah, oh, I'm a bit slow today. You get issues with copyright with the, some of the music that comes up on the radio. So yeah, I want to be really careful with that, so I might just edit that out so that we don't get any strikes on our channel. The last thing I want is my channel being shut down because I've had copyright strikes on the music. So let's just move that out there. It sounds like the mill has just started up again. Yes, it has. That's excellent. So that is now running again. It's a noisy contraption, this thing. So yeah, we've got 7 weeks left. Is this week plus another 6 full weeks. And in order for us to run for these 7 weeks, I'm going to ask a couple more questions about this map. However, next week, I will ask the question about where we're moving to next. What do I want to do now? I want to get up to the top field so that we can keep that combine up there running, because we have to do the poplars before we finish. So we're going to have to get the field up the top done. That's got to be harvested. and the bales cleared out the way, and then we can go and plant the poplars, and then we've got to harvest them. I want to get that done. That's the one thing that we must get done before we leave this map. So next week I will be asking where we're going to go next. After we've done our 100 episodes, we now have a time scale on this map. We are going to stay here for another 7 weeks. That's including this week. So we will be here for 101 episodes in total. 101. No more, no less. And then after that, we are going to move. I'm already thinking up some different places for us to go. Some of them I think are absolutely awesome. I'm still not sure if I'm going to include a British map in the options this time round, because, well, quite frankly, given the huge popularity of the British maps, it does tend to divide the community a little. And there are so many other really, really cool maps out there that I've seen. I might wait until next move before I include a British map in the options. I'm not sure yet, though. It's something I'm still thinking about. One of the maps I'm definitely going to include is Goral. I think it's Goral. Is it Goral or Goral? I'm not sure how it's pronounced. The one with 103 different fields. It's got some bigger fields, some smaller fields. Some of them are able to be ploughed in together. It looks fantastic. It's on the mod hub in the beta section, and it just looks incredible. I've already fallen in love with that map. So that's kind of, that's one of my top favorites. Another one that I'd like to include, and I really can't remember the name for it at the moment, it's set in Spain, and it's quite a lot of hills in it. There's a lot of fields in it again. There's 80 something fields in that map, and it's got hills everywhere. So there's quite a lot of steeper ground. And so that's one I'd like to include. I've had people begging me to do something set in Holland or somewhere like that that's all flat, because obviously there it's when you've got just flat ground rather than lots of hills and stuff, it's completely different style of farming. And a lot of people have been asking me to look for a map like that. So this week, this is your chance to start sending me links to maps. And if it's an external map, one that isn't on Mod Hub, it's going to have to be pretty good, because it's more difficult for people after the series is run to install the correct edition of a map, whereas in Mod Hub it's automatically updated. You don't tend to sort of run into problems like that. It's a bit more difficult for people after it's finished to be able to correctly install the right version of the map so that they can continue on a save game, stuff like that. And I don't want to make it difficult for people. Now then, I've made this difficult for myself. We're just going to have to drive on the crop, I think, because I can't go up on there and empty the combine out. And I don't want to just drive over and sell one tank a week, because it's going to affect the prices. We're at the 78,000. We've got 789 there. How much are we getting here? Mary's Farm. Right, agribusiness, 627. It's dropping. It's not a bad price, I suppose. No, we won't do that now. Let me just go forward. We'll have to drive on the crop just for this little bit, and then we can set the hired help going and he can carry right on. So we move up there, and it is sort of reaching. I know that we are clipping right into the side. It's not very good. This trailer is actually a little bit too high for this combine, but it's something I'm prepared to live with, because I'd like to just get this field done so that we can get poplars planted up here. That has got to be our priority. We've got to focus on these poplars. We're also going to be looking at the slow bee pack and introducing those placeables. So I'm going to sort of be breaking away quite a bit from regular farming on here for the rest of the series, in hope that it's going to sort of make it a bit more interesting for people. Because like I said, I do understand where you're coming from, where quite a few of you have said you're starting to get bored with being on this map. So I'm trying... This is one of the hardest things in the world, is to try to keep everybody happy. And I am trying to keep everybody happy. And yeah, I don't know how successful it's going to be, but I am going to attempt to keep everybody happy. So yeah, we'll see. We'll see how that pans out for us. And that one can carry on there. And I'm going to get back down. I'll just go and switch this engine off. I'm going to get back down to the main yard. Actually, no, dealership. That's where we want to go next. We want to go to the dealership. We've got a line of balers over there. We're not going to be using any of those today. However, what I might do, we've got the Coon Baler We've got the Coon Round Baler. And do we have any other Coon stuff? Because when I come to release this map for the save game file, I'm going to upload the save game file. Sosnyovka is up on the... Sosnyovka is on the on FSUK. It's all uploaded there so people can use it however they like. I am going to remove anything from the Coon DLC. We've got a couple of things in this map that are from the Coon DLC. So that one there, I'm going to get rid of that one, I think. I think we've got enough silage and stuff to keep us going now. The reason being, not everybody has got the Coon DLC, and I'm not going to give you an upload... I'm not going to give you a save game file that forces you to go and buy it. So I will remove those. But anyway, I will meet you over at the dealership. We've got something else to take a look at today, which I think is just awesome. Okay, I'm going to do the slow reveal on this one. And here we go. And yes, there we go. We have a baler with great big wheels on it like that. That looks fantastic, doesn't it? And oh, yes, it's a self-propelled baler with the whole pickup and everything. And I've seen a picture of this. It's only just been released. I think I had to look long and hard to try to find the original link for this. I think I have got the original link. Yes, it is a bit of a mashup. You've got the baler. It looks like you've got the chassis for one of the New Holland combines. And you've got a some sort of pickup reel there. I'm not quite sure. It does look like just a mashup of everything that is in the game already, which is fine. I can live with that. I absolutely don't mind whatsoever. These are a real thing. Not this exactly. You don't have case on the front, case cab with New Holland baler and everything. That bit, yeah, it's... I've seen a Fent one, someone on our channel called, a fan of the channel called Darker, I think it is. He actually linked me a video to a Fent self-propelled baler, and there are a few different ones in the world. There are, there's several different ones in the world that are actually self-propelled, big balers like this. You get, there's also self-propelled small balers, and the self-propelled small baler didn't really make it as any kind of product, really. It wasn't successful, because when they released it, the world was moving away from small bales. Most farmers now don't use small bales. There are some places that small bale is still the predominant choice by farmers. However, most places in the world now go for big bales. It's either brown bales or the big square ones. So by the time the self-propelled small baler came out, it simply wasn't economically feasible for the company. I think it was New Holland that did it, and I don't know if any other company tried a self-propelled baler. New Holland did that, and they also did a self-propelled bale collector as well. So they really did sort of push out the small bale stuff, and I don't know why exactly they stopped doing it, but most of the small bale sort of gathering and stuff and that I've seen, there's a lot of New Holland in it. There's some other manufacturers as well, but New Holland seemed to be the main one. We'll have to go up to the top in a minute and unload the other baler. The combine. Go and unload the combine. However, today we are just leasing this one. We're not actually buying it. I would like to just give it a go. My weekly question. I completely forgot, didn't I? I got sidetracked. I was thinking of asking whether we should keep this one, but I don't think we will. We've got another baler. This is just going to be a one-off. We'll do this harvest with it, and then we'll see. So, yeah, my question is, I'm going to buy a few more animals before we leave here in another 7 weeks' time. Which animals do you want me to get? Do you want me to focus on cattle, or do you want me to focus on sheep? I don't really think we've got enough time or money to be able to sort of go for both in any kind of scale. So do you want me to just concentrate on sheep, or do you want me to just concentrate on cows, or do you actually want me to go for an even spread of the two? By even spread, I will literally just buy 20 sheep and 20 cows each time, or 10 sheep and 10 cows each time that we buy some. Or we can just concentrate on cows and spend spare money on cows, or just concentrate on sheep. It's your vote, it's your game. Head in the comment section down below, let us know what you would like and why. And of course, don't forget to actually cast your vote in the top right-hand corner. And around here. So, Helper B is a full grain tank. I'm going to go up there a minute, and I'm going to deal with that. I know we still got the Ponzi Scorpion there, and we do want to cut down some more trees. But we're going to do the baling first. get this out of the way. The scorpion is just going to hang around for a while, I think. We're going to sort of keep it going. So that we can drag some more trees back over to the sawmill. That's, yeah, we'll get to that. But anyway, I will get up to the top, empty that one out, and I'll meet you back down here when the combine is going again. Right, here we go. Let's see how the self-propelled baler works. I have been looking forward to this since I first seen it. That starts up quite nicely, and lower down, so we got a good animation on it. That works fine. I haven't actually tested this at all. I did originally mean to test it on my test maps to make sure there's no crashes or anything like that, but I've decided to take the risk because I ran out of time to just go for it. And I love the animation on the pickup. I like the way that it's kind of spreading the straw out quite nicely before it then feeds into the machine. I think that's a really good touch. And we look out the back. There is our first bale coming off of the press. There we go. First bale. Excellent. And you don't need to worry about doing short turns if you don't. I mean, obviously, here it's more sort of economic to go to the second one, but you could just go up one row and down the next one. We don't have to worry about turning tight on the PTO shaft or damaging anything like that. You can turn as tight as you like. Absolutely fantastic. And I would sincerely hope that right there is a camera that is pointing to the back so that when you're in the cab, you would have somewhere in, well, this is the combine. It's the combine cab, so it's obviously it's going to be a little bit different to kind of what I'm hoping for. But I would hope that there would be a screen in here that you could see a video feed to the back of the machine so that you can see what the bale's doing. So if you need to do any backing up or anything like that, you can without any problems at all. So, fantastic mod. Absolutely brilliant. I really hope that some people can bring out some other variations of this to generally make it look like a real machine rather than one that has sort of been cobbled together from bits of combine and that in the game. I mean, I guess actually if you've got a mechanically minded farmer who's pretty switched on with what he's doing with stuff, this would actually be quite realistic. Because he could just sort of grab bits and pieces from any machine he liked and cobble it all together. So yeah, I don't know. What do you guys think? Let's have your views and opinions on this particular machine. Do you think it looks realistic? Could you picture any farmer just or a farmer that at least is like mechanically minded? Could you picture someone building something like this, or do you think that this is sort of almost beyond the realms of realism for what a farmer could do? You would expect something like this to just sort of be a factory-issued machine like the Fent one that I seen the video of. And I got to say, I would love to be able to drive a self-propelled baler. I think that would be a lot of fun. Having spent quite a long time driving a baler on the back of a tractor, I think driving a self-propelled one would be absolutely brilliant. It would be absolutely fantastic. It's the whole combine cab on the front, because the one thing I genuinely loved about driving combines is being able to look down like that. You've got such a fantastic field of view. You can see everything that's going on, and obviously your head is further forward than this, so you do get a better view than this of what's going on in front of you. Absolutely awesome. Genuinely awesome being able to drive a combine and do things like that. So yeah, I would very much like to be able to drive something like this in real life. I think it would be great fun. Absolutely fantastic to do. You know, we really should be picking the header up when we come round to the end of the row. You can turn nice and sharp. Look at that. Oh, this is awesome. I really do love this machine. This is absolutely brilliant. I know I'm weaving around a little bit. I'm trying to sort of show you all angles of the machine while it's working. And so it's not easy to sort of keep in a straight line, but look at this thing. This is just incredible. How could anybody not love this machine? I am so pleased I found this. Right, we're going to use this one for all of the bales for this harvest. And yes, just put in the comment section if you think that I should just keep this one on lease until the end of the series, and we'll get rid of the other balers. We'll get rid of the small baler. I don't think we need that one anymore. We'll get rid of the Coon DLC one for the silage, because I don't think we need that one anymore. We've got enough for the cattle for now. Actually, no, we'll keep hold of it for a minute, because we may need to do more silage. If we do get more cattle, we may need to do more silage. So we'll sort of see how that works out. Come around here, pick the header up, whizzing over. He's got a good turn of speed on him. He does 32 miles an hour, which is, that's pretty impressive, really. And let's come up through here. That's actually faster than any of the combines or any of the, got a slightly wider feed here. Right, help would be as a full grain tank. So we'll finish this field. Then I will go and empty out the grain tank again so that we can keep that one moving. And then we can come back to do a little bit more baling. We'll do that little field over there next. Do we want to use an artisan on this field, the bale stacker, or do we just stick with the Tatra and the auto load trailer? I quite like the auto load trailer. It's quite nice just to be able to whiz up and down the field with that one and grab everything really quickly. But I am aware that some of you don't like the sort of break from realism with them. So maybe we could get... I don't remember if we've got an artisan at the moment or not. Let's just take a quick look. Do we have an artisan? Garage. We certainly wouldn't have one owned, I wouldn't have said. No. So let's go into our leased machinery. We've got trailers. We've got all sorts of stuff here. Conveyor belts. Right, there's the stuff from the Coon DLC. It's those three. So we will return... those, actually, we don't need this one and this one anymore, do we? We're not going to do any more row crops. At least I don't think we will. We'll hang on to it just for a minute, but I will get rid of it before the end of the series. And the rest of the stuff that we got here, we got all sorts of balers and everything. But we don't have an artisan. Right, so, yeah. Should we get an artisan or should we just stick with a straight autoload? All I was going to do with the artisan, I'm not going to move it anywhere in particular... I would stack it up on the field and we'll just sort of gather all the bales up into a group, and then once that's done, then we go with the auto load. And this is where you need the camera on the back, because you wouldn't be able to see very well. Obviously you've got your mirrors so you can see a bit, but it would be better if you could, if you had a camera, you could see if there were any bales right behind you, which could damage the back of the machine if you were backing into a bale. So what do you think? Artisan and pick the bales up and just sort of group them in the field, and then go and park beside each of the piles of bales, sort of all grouped up together, and then load them with auto load? Or do we just say go for it and take the... Auto load. Auto load. Yeah, just take the auto load trailer, the Flegel. The Flegel, that was the word I was looking for. Take the Flegel auto load and just run up and down the field with it really quickly and grab all the bales. How would you like me to approach this particular task? Let me know. But obviously today, the most important discussion in a comment section is what map do we go to next? I've been getting a lot of requests for maps based in Holland. Both Holland and the Netherlands, and... as far as I know, they are actually separate areas. I'm always a little bit confused about which is Holland and which is the Netherlands, and where does one finish and where does one start, and because some people will refer to Holland and the Netherlands as being the same thing, but as far as I know, they're not the same thing. It's two separate countries, or the Netherlands is a separate area but part of Holland. I'm not sure. And I really should know, because you guys are my neighbours. It's like your country is literally just across the channel from us. So I really should know a bit more about you than I do. So please educate me. Let me know about that one. But if there's any maps based in Holland or the Netherlands, send me some links so that I can take a look at them. And we will see about using putting one of those into the vote. I think that could be quite good. At the moment, though, Gural, whichever it is, which is based in... Poland, I think it is definitely my personal favourite, but we will have to wait and see. So the map vote will be next week, so even if you don't watch any other episodes for this week, please come back next week so you can have your say on what the future series will be. I'll probably even include it in the title so that people that aren't watching this series anymore can at least see that and have a say in the next one. At least I hope that's what's going to happen. So let's come on up through here. I did actually say I was going to go up to the other field, didn't I? I'll go up the other field. I will empty out that combine again. And then I will come back and we can finish doing this little field. And then Actually, we're going to have to say fairly well, because we're just about run out of time. Right, the combine is running again, and we're running again down here. So, yeah, like I was saying, I want to hear your opinions on maps. I've had quite a few people asking for Drummard Farm, which is a smallish farm set in Ireland. That one seems to be fairly popular already. So that could could very well be one of the vote ones. I don't know yet. I haven't had a look at it. I don't know if it's sort of suitable for what I want for the map on this end of the week, or if I would prefer that one to be for the other end of the week. Because remember, really, we want to be focusing on big scale farming on this end of the week, doing things on a large scale. So like Gural is lots and lots of small fields, and there are some big fields. So we would be doing, it's kind of like doing small scale farming. However, I think that it's okay to include it this end of the week, because it's small scale farming on a big scale. With 103 different fields, we're going to need to be doing quite a few different things at once, and multitasking. There's three separate farms on the map. You start off with a couple of fields next to each of the three farms. So you've got, if you've only got a few machines, you've got movement between the two map, between the fields, or you've got to have three separate groups of machinery at the three separate farms. And what I thought, because we do large-scale stuff at this end of the week, I thought if we were to do that map, we would run three separate groups of machinery. We wouldn't keep traveling between the farms with the same machinery unless it was like some big stuff. I'm not quite sure how we would do it yet. But really, kind of the one thing I would like to do on that map is, if you know, obviously if it wins the vote, is we would run three separate groups of machines. And so part of what it would be an exercise in large-scale management where we've sort of, right, we want to get a tractor, but we need a tractor for two different locations, so we've either got to buy one big one that we can move between the two, or we buy two slightly smaller ones. I think it can be very interesting getting things set up for something like that. I haven't actually been on the map and had a look around it. I've just sort of seen the screenshots and pictures and what people have told me. Someone did say it can be quite difficult to move your gear around on that map because of small roads and that, but at least I think it was that map they were talking about. There's several maps like that, which I particularly like. I like the challenge of having to move things around like that, purely because that's sort of very much like how we do things in the UK. You've got very, very tiny roads everywhere in the UK. Well, not everywhere. Certainly where I live, anyway. You've got really small roads, and the fields are starting to get bigger and the machines are starting to get bigger. So you've got the challenge of trying to move a big machine down a road where you're literally scraping the banks on each side of the road. And we've got big, tall, solid hedges everywhere that you go, not just fences or open ground. So it does make it really difficult to move your things around. If you've got a great big solid stone granite hedge, because granite is the most of the stone where I am, although there's some areas not far from me that everything is built with slate, and you've got big chunks of slate everywhere. So if you've got all your hedges and your stone walls built out of this stuff, you don't want to be driving your machines into it. You don't want to even have them touching the hedges, because it will just do it. It'll do some damage, right? You're not going to win a fight with a granite hedge. It's never going to happen. It's kind of nice to be able to get on a map where we've got that challenge, because like this map and Sosnovka, the one thing that I didn't particularly like about those maps is the fact that there's no boundaries on the roads and nothing really around the fields as well. Like here, wherever we go, I drove the combine from this field up to field one with the header on it, partly because that is the way that things can be moved around in the States. And it does make things a lot quicker. So it's nice to be able to do that. But that just would never happen in the UK. I've never worked anywhere in the UK that you would even be able to do that. I've gone way, way over time again. So let me just go in here. And my weekly question. Do you want me to get more sheep? Do you want me to get more cows? Or do you want me to get a spread of the two? We've got 7 weeks left. And so obviously we've not got a huge amount of time, but I would like to get a few more animals before we finish up on this map. So which would you like me to get? Would you like me to just go for sheep, just go for cows, or would you like me to spread our last remaining money sort of between the two lots of animals? It's your vote, it's your game. Head in the comment section down below, let us know what you want and why, and of course don't forget to actually cast your vote in the bottom top right hand corner. I am going to Actually, I'll probably finish this baling at the beginning of the next episode. We'll do, maybe I'll do a little bit more. And the combining can continue. We've got some trees to cut down. But first of all, we've got to go and gather up all of the bales. And I just actually had a thought. I was telling you to tell me how you'd like me to go and gather the bales. But actually, that is going to be an exercise in futility because obviously I'm going to be recording everything before even this video goes live. So I'm not going to be able to see your responses to that particular question. Well, actually, I will. I will be able to see it for field one. So these fields here, I will just gather them up using the autoload. But then field one, if you want me to get the Arkazan up there, then you can still, yeah, still talk about it, because I don't think we'll get to field one bale gathering this week. It'll probably be at the beginning of next week. But yeah. So anyway, if you've enjoyed this episode, then please head down below and give us a like. And if you really liked it, then please tell your friends all about me. Get them to come and watch as well. That would be awesome. But until next time, thank you very much for watching. This is Frithgar. Goodbye, and see you later.